Introduction: Multilingualism is a skill possessed by individuals who can communicate in more than one language. This chapter introduces the neural structures that deal with multiple languages and discusses the factors affecting the neural organization within multilinguals. All people possess the ability to communicate in at least one language, which is called their native language. These individuals are referred to as monolinguals, and people who can communicate in more than one language are referred to as polyglots. The native language, or commonly referred to as one lira, is a bit tricky to distinguish in simultaneous polyglots who learned multiple languages at the same time during early development. However, there is usually a slight preference for one language, and for simplicity, that language is designated the individual's one lira, which then makes other subsequent languages two lira, three lira, etc. In successive polyglots, assigning of one lira, two lira is simple because each language learned subsequently gets assigned chronologically. A multitude of studies have been carried out to assess the neural organization within polyglots through neuroimaging techniques, while subjects were administered different tasks. A few tasks and their subsequent neural activation shall be discussed later in this chapter. For an in-depth analysis of single language localization within the brain, please refer to previous chapters within this online textbook. Factors affecting neural organization of multilinguals. The neural organization of language is affected by multiple factors, such as the age of two lira acquisition, the degree of proficiency attained in each language, the method two lira was taught, individual variability, etc. Different methods of teaching two lira might favor different strategies for language processing, and hence distinct cerebral circuits. In terms of age of acquisition, multiple studies suggest that people who learn a language later in life do not generally achieve the same level of proficiency as native speakers. Birdsong, 1999, Johnson and Newport, 1989. The causes of these age effects in language performance vary widely from a biologically based critical period to the differences between infant and adult learning contexts. Lindberg, 1967. For learners below the age of 18, age of exposure was strongly correlated with success in grammar attainment of two lira and no significant effect of aptitude level. However, young adults between ages 18 and 40 showed opposite results, where aptitude was the main determinant in ultimate grammatical attainment, rather than age of exposure. Furthermore, for the oldest learners over the age of 40, neither aptitudes nor age of arrival were good predictors of two lira grammar attainment. Dekeser et al. 2009. The age of two lira acquisition seems critical for grammatical processing, whereas lexical semantic processing is less affected by age of acquisition, but rather correlated with level of two lira proficiency. Wartenberger et al. 2003. Results from the imaging study showed no difference in brain activations between one lira and two lira during grammatical tasks for early and proficient bilinguals, while highly proficient yet late two lira acquisitioned individuals showed additional neural activation. In lexical semantic processing, no differences were found irrespective of age of two lira acquisition, but great differences were found with varying proficiency. Wartenberger et al. 2003. Another interesting find using voxel-based morphometry is that early acquisition highly proficient subjects have increased gray matter density in the inferior parietal cortex, which is the area associated with two lira proficiency. These results suggest that language talent in polyglots resides within the left inferior parietal lobe. McKelly et al. 2004. Critical period hypothesis: performance results in two lira of adults, even experienced two lira users, hints that the ability of effectively acquiring in two lira is limited by a critical period. The critical period hypothesis suggested by Lindberg, 1967, is dependent on the assumption that age-related effects in two lira studies are a consequence of changes in brain structures due to maturation, and these structures are critical in the learning and processing of language. The notion of a sensitive period for language acquisition comes from the loss of flexibility for cerebral reorganization after puberty. Skovel, 1988, Pitkowski, 1980, 1990, Sakai, 2005. Other studies have proposed that age-related changes in two lira performance arise from the nature and extent of the interaction between one lira and two lira. Oyama, 1979, Fliege, 1987, 1988, 1995, 1998b, Bialystok, 1997. This approach assumes that the more developed an one lira system is when two lira is being learned, the more influence one lira will have on two lira learning. The debate between maturation and interaction, however, are still unresolved, and as suggested, neural development and one lira acquisition during childhood is extremely complex. Bates and Goodman, 1998. The length and duration of the critical period for two-lira acquisition also has not been successfully established. Some argue that it ends at 12 years of age, Scovell, 1988, whereas according to others, Petkowski, 1990, it ends at age 15. Lenberg, 1967, suggests that puberty is the end of the critical period, which is problematic since it is highly variable between individuals. Successful language acquisition requires different linguistic abilities which develop according to their own developmental timeline. Therefore, in addition to an acquisition critical period, linguistic ability may also have its own critical period, and both these critical periods may have to overlap in order to attain native-like proficiency in two-lira, Sakai, 2005. Two-lira acquisition after the critical period is different in nature from critical period learning because of the requirement for a more conscious, labored effort. Studies have also shown a slow systematic decline in macroscopic levels of brain metabolism, as well as synaptic density between the ages of 4 and 20, Bates et al. 1992. Assuming there is a critical period for language acquisition, late 2-lira acquisition will likely resemble 1-lira acquisition because the process will be governed by the same neural structure. Therefore, 2-lira acquisition during the critical period should have little or no influence from 1-lira because of similar access to the construction of a language system. Learning 2-lira after the critical period, however, would reflect elements of 1-lira because available resources would be activated and they would begin with the linguistic structures already in place, Bialystok and Hakuta, 1999. In contrast, another theory claims that the processing of 2-lira acquired late in life depends upon different cognitive mechanisms and cerebral structures from 1-lira, Ullman, 2001. In this regard, 2-lira grammatical knowledge is declarative, while 1-lira is implicit, whereas both 1-lira and 2-lira are declarative for lexical knowledge. Since implicit and declarative knowledge are mediated by distinct neural systems, left frontal basal ganglia and left temporal areas respectively, this differential hypothesis claims that late 2-lira acquisition cannot depend on the same brain mechanisms used for 1-lira, Ullman, 2001. Neural anatomy and language macroscopic brain functional neuroimaging studies have shown that highly proficient bilinguals activate the same set of brain regions irrespective of language, Pirani, 2005. This suggests highly overlapping and interconnected neural circuits, but do not indicate how the brain controls or determines which language to use. Anatomically, the bilingual brain cannot be summarized as the sum of two monolingual language systems, but rather should be represented as a unique and complex neural system that differs in each individual. Monolinguals appear to consistently activate relatively fixed left hemispheric network groups, but polyglots with 2-lira learned later in life and with less attained proficiency activate non-overlapping and less consistent cerebral areas. However, when prosciency was kept constant, age of acquisition did not seem to have a major impact on brain representations of 2-lira, Abutalebi et al. 2001. The cerebral network for reading should operate differently between the 1-lira and 2-lira languages, since it has been shown that even proscient bilinguals are slower to recognize 2-lira than 1-lira, Granger and Bovell in 1987, Jiang, 1999, Thomas and Allport, 2000. It is inconclusive whether and to what extent the bilingual brain can ultimately decode 2-lira automatically without effortful cognitive control. It has been shown that even before processing lexical information, bilinguals filter out the non-target language, Rodriguez-Fornells et al. 2002. This control is speculated to occur within the left occipitotemporal cortex, since this region is sensitive to language-specific orthographic patterns and has control over an early and unconscious stage of reading, Dehaney et al. 2001, Nakamura et al. 2005, Vinkier et al. 2007. Voluntary regulation is needed to control the left inferolateral frontal cortex, involved in switching between languages for speech production and reading aloud, Fabro et al. 2000, Hernandez et al. 2001, Price et al. 1999. The left occipitotemporal cortex is thought to house semantic-level representations of the languages and therefore may exhibit differential sensitivity to 2-lira, Chertko et al. 1997, Devlin et al. 2004, Nakamura et al. 2007. Evidence exists to support a general-purpose cognitive control system in the inferolateral prefrontal cortex to resolve connect between languages by enhancing neural representations of task-relevant information in posterior temporal cortex based on the language in use, Enner and Hirsch 2005. Multiple neuropsychological and imaging studies have failed to establish consistent neuronal substrates for 2-lira acquisition, perhaps because they were obtained in various languages, differences between languages, differences in tasks, subject proficiency variability, and also inter-subject variability. Neural activation during linguistic tasks, verbal fluency tasks, verbal fluency tasks, showed consistent brain activity involved in the left lateral prefrontal cortex, and in particular, the inferior and middle frontal gyrus. Additional brain activity in the left hemisphere was located in the premotor cortex, the inferior parietal lobe, the superior and middle temporal gyri, and the thalamus. A few right hemispheric brain activations were also found in the inferior frontal gyrus and right cerebellum. Production of two lira words caused significant activations in the left inferior and middle frontal gyri, left premotor cortex, and insula. Further activity was also observed in the left inferior parietal lobe, left caudate nucleus, and right inferior frontal gyrus. A more concentrated activation was observed in 1 lira word production tasks within the left frontal lobe, specifically in the inferior and middle frontal gyri and insula, Pirani et al. 2003. Word generation tasks of increasing task difficulty showed brain activity in Brodmann areas 45, 46, and 47, in the left inferior and middle frontal gyrus. These areas are associated with the selection processes of information among competing alternatives from semantic memory. These cortical areas would be specifically activated on the basis of task difficulty, when the word to be generated possessed more competing alternatives, a larger left prefrontal network was involved, Thompson Schill et al. 1997, 1999. In word generation or other production tasks, there is evidence that a lower degree of language proficiency may be associated with differences in brain activity in anterior brain structures, such as Broca's area and the basal ganglia, Chi et al. 1999, Yetkin et al. 1996. In comprehension tasks, however, the temporal lobe was associated with proficiency-related differences, Dehaney et al. 1997, Pirani et al. 1996, 1998. More extensive cerebral activations are associated with production of the less proficient language and smaller activations when comprehending the less proficient language. In effortful tasks such as word generation, the difference in activation can be attributed to the recruitment of additional resources. In language comprehension, the less extensive activation associated with the less proficient language may react to more limited knowledge of the linguistic material, Abutalebi et al. 2001. Reading tasks. During reading tasks, cerebral networks showed differential activation between 1 lira and 2 lira, but common brain regions such as the bilateral occipitotemporal cortex, bilateral medial frontal areas, and the left inferior parietal and left lateral prefrontal areas were activated in both languages, Nakamura et al. 2010. These results support the dual root connection hypothesis, stating that words between 1 lira and 2 lira are directly linked at the lexical level and indirectly linked at the semantic level. Further neuropsychological evidence shows that the left lateral temporal cortex is involved in lexicosemantic processing during reading tasks, Chertko et al. 1997. The medial temporal gyrus is thought to be involved in lexical activation, since a region just posterior to it shows increasingly greater response as letter strings become more like real words, Vinkier et al. 2007. The language non-selective frontal gyrus medial temporal gyrus stream probably mediates lexical activation in each language, but not interlanguage lexical activation or semantic activation. Post-lexical mapping of word form to meaning in the left medial temporal gyrus is much less automatic for 2 lira and compensated by an effortful cognitive control for amplifying the lexicosemantic association between each language, Nakamura et al. 2010. Mental counting tasks produced similar activations for all 1 lira languages, with prominent left frontal activation in Broca's area and medial frontal or cingulate areas. The cingulate areas concurrently activated the left superior parietal lobule, and a small right anterior region was. In addition to these activations, 2 lira languages also activated posterior left temporal regions, Vingerhits et al. 2003. In mental picture naming tasks, superior medial frontal and extensive bilateral occipital activation was observed for all 1 lira languages, whereas 2 lira languages additionally activated left frontal regions including Broca's area and left superior parietal and temporal occipital areas, Vingerhits et al. 2003. Mental language production experiments found Broca's area differentially activated for early versus late bilinguals, where similar activations were seen for 1 lira and 2 lira in early learners, and spatially segregated activations in late learners, Kim et al. 1997. Verb generation tasks. Verb generation tasks produce reduced brain activity in the left frontal lobe following practice, mainly related to processing differences between high and low practice performance. The reduction in prefrontal activation after repeated practice suggests a decreased dependence on controlled processing. In terms of language processing, increased practice does not correlate to increased proficiency, but rather a greater exposure to the language being used. Intensive exposure to a language in a bilingual environment will lead to a lower activation threshold and a higher degree of automaticity, thereby decreased dependence on controlled and attentional processing, Green, 1986. Intense generation tasks. Cortical plasticity for 2 lira gets increasingly similar to 1 lira. Specialization in the inferior lateral gyrus, despite noticeable differences in their performance and linguistic knowledge between 1 lira and 2 lira. If proficiency level was higher, however, the activation in the left dorsal inferior frontal gyrus was lower, indicating that proficiency plays a large role in activation of this area, Sakai, 2005. This finding makes sense because during early acquisition of 2 lira when proficiency is low, the cortical regions have to be strongly elicited, whereas when proficiency gets high enough the process becomes automated, reducing the need for activating the left dorsal inferior frontal gyrus. Listening tasks. Listening tasks to 1 lira showed remarkable consistency in the observed activated areas in the left hemisphere. All subjects showed activity in the left temporal lobe along the superior temporal sulcus, as well as portions of the superior and middle temporal gyri. Some showed activation in the temporal pole, and others the left angular gyrus. Although similar activity was occasionally found in the right temporal lobe, including the right superior temporal sulcus and temporal pole, it was always weaker, highly variable from subject to subject, and never extended into the right angular gyrus. Outside the temporal lobe, the only consistent focus of activation was found near the intersection of the inferior frontal sulcus and the precentral sulcus around Brodmann's areas 6, 8, 9 and 44, Dehaney et al. 1997. Listening to 2 lira showed much greater inter-subject variability, and there was no significant similarity in anatomically activated areas between the subjects. In a few subjects there were some activation similarity to 1 lira in the same areas of the left temporal lobe, but much more dispersed in comparison. No activity was found in the left temporal pole and angular gyrus when listening to 2 lira. When subjects did show left temporal activity in 2 lira, the activation volume was smaller than in 1 lira, and activated additional small subregions in the right temporal lobe, mostly the right superior temporal gyrus and sulcus, Dehaney et al. 1997. Cerebral activations outside the temporal lobe was also observed while listening to 2 lira, but were highly variable. Some showed a highly specific activation of the left inferior frontal gyrus, Broca's area, and of the inferior precentral sulcus in 2 lira, but not in 1 lira. Others showed activity in the left and right anterior cingulate when listening to 2 lira, but not 1 lira. Yet another few showed frontal activation at a region similarly activated in 1 lira, the intersection of the inferior frontal sulcus and the precentral gyrus. Dehaney et al. 1997. The anterior cingulate region is known to be active and attentive, controlled or processing tasks, implicating that the subjects had to engage greater attentional resources for processing 2 lira, compared to the more automatized 1 lira. These results indicate that 1 lira acquisition relies on a dedicated left hemispheric cerebral network, while late 2 lira acquisition is associated with variable cortical substrates based on individual differences. Priming tasks. During priming tasks, irrespective of language, semantically related prime and target words reduce the activation of the left anterior temporal cortex. This finding suggests that different languages use the same neuronal populations within the temporal cortex, rather than activating different neurons within the same region. However, in the head of the left caudate, only semantically related words of similar language were primed and therefore reduced activation. Two proposed mechanisms for these results have been suggested, with the first being: within this neural region, different languages are processed by language-selective neural populations, and for the prime language, semantic priming selectively adapts the activations of neuronal populations. There was no reduction in activation of semantic primes between different languages, because the change in language activated a different neuronal population, Grill Spector et al. 2006. The second proposed mechanism is that the same neuronal populations respond to similar semantic primes, but increase firing when the languages are different. This indicates that the neuronal populations have the ability to distinguish difference between similar or distinct language primes and manipulate their firing accordingly, Notton and et al. 1997. Alternative studies have suggested that the left caudate is required to monitor and control lexical, as well as multilanguage synonym production. The highest responses in the left caudate are seen when there is a change in language or a change in meaning, but lowest when the context of words are related in both language and meaning. Morphologically, the left caudate receives projections from frontal, temporal, and parietal association regions in the language-dominant hemisphere connections back to these areas via the thalamus. These connections play a critical role in controlling and selecting automatic motor sequences, such as those necessary for articulation. A mechanism sensitive to the language being used is needed, since the motor patterns differ across languages, and the head of the left caudate may be ideally situated to serve this function. Functional neuroimaging studies have demonstrated that neuronal responses in the head of the left caudate are sensitive to both the semantic content and the language of written words, Crinion et al. 2006. The left caudate is crucial in language control, so further research involving the cortical structures connected to the left caudate is critical in the progress of understanding neural control of multiple languages. Unconscious neural priming is language non-selective during bilingual word recognition in the left midfusiform gyrus, but exhibits a preference for one lira in the left posterior middle temporal gyrus, Nakamura et al. 2010. Summary: multiple factors influence the neural organization of language within an individual, such as age of acquisition, proficiency of the language, individual variability, etc. Successful language acquisition seems to be restricted by a certain critical period early on in development, but the exact range of the critical period has not yet been determined. Attainment of native-like proficiency in an 2 lira language is restricted by this critical period, but 2 lira can be learned at any time throughout life. Learning a language later on in life, however, is more labor-intensive, as more neural resources are recruited to translate 2 lira to 1 lira in order to comprehend. Additionally, a person who learned a new language post-critical period already has a language established, and therefore the new language will be developed in comparison to the native language. This can cause a lot of obstacles because of the grave differences between many languages in terms of grammar and structure. Overall, language is localized to the left hemisphere of the cerebral cortex. Highly proficient multilinguals who acquired all their languages within the critical period and are equally proficient in all their languages activate the similar neuronal populations when using either language. However, a less proficient multilingual activates the same neuronal population as a proficient individual, but recruits additional neural populations depending on the task. As an individual gets more proficient in a language, the neural activations decrease and more closely resemble the activations of a native speaker. However, even a highly proficient individual will never depict the same activations as a native speaker if the language was acquired after the critical period.